we are respectively asking the court to look at its record and to note that our opposition is respondents, and that's who we are in this court, and therefore not to shut us out, but give us our time to highlight, just like the other parties. I respectfully urge that the court ought not to lock out even the interested parties, but I speak on behalf of the 74th, 75th, 76th respondents, that we too require our time to highlight certain issues before this court. We urge the court not to lock us out, not to reduce us to spectators before this court, because then we wouldn't need to be here. We would have just given our submissions and not come to court. We are here as respondents, and we respectfully ask the court not to lock us out, not to change our status. Nobody has complained that we are respondents. Nobody has challenged that. And the court has not asked us to comment on it before changing our status to that of a mission.
This is one of the cases where we should not have any time limit at all. If it is necessary for us to sit in this court for 2 months, let us do so. If it is necessary to sit for 6 months, the way I sat in the case of Mr. Motieno, let us do so. What is the hurry for? Where are we going? We have a unique case of national dimension. We have a unique case of international dimension. The entire international legal profession is focused on what is going on in Kenya about this case. And for us to say that the case so-and-so will take 15 minutes, so-and-so will take 45 minutes, may I say with tremendous respect, we are being very mundane. We should be able to see this case in a much broader perspective. And the broader perspective is that your lordships or your ladyships and your lordship should sit and hear the matter for as long as it's necessary. Give us time. The Honorable Attorney General, I rarely agree with him, but this time I agree with him. Why should you give the Attorney General of the land 45 minutes? He deserves much more. He should be able to say what he wants to say. With those few remarks, I urge you that you retire and reconsider your position. We should not treat this case as a debt collection case the way we normally do, of 10 minutes or 15 minutes. For once, let us sit and do some work, all of us, the bench and the legal profession.
We have only one submission, which is to associate with my learned friend, Mr. George Oraro, in the plea for a little bit more time in which the parties who are entitled to address you may address you. In our case, we consider that 45 minutes may not be sufficient to argue a matter that has very broad implications, which is the quorum and the function of IEBC. If we have looked at the record in the High Court and the record in the Court of Appeal, and it's quite clear that very major errors of law and fact were made precisely because time was not sufficiently allocated. That is our plea, milady.
It is our view that this matter should be fully ventilated. The matter, although being heard and considered by the court, but there's a great deal of public interest in this matter. The Kenyan people would want to know the arguments and the positions of the various parties as ventilated before the court. They don't have the privilege of having the written submissions. And my lady and the court, this is probably the one of the most important cases that would ever come before the Supreme Court on the Constitution. Secondly, my lady, we appear for the two respondents. We filed joint submissions. In the submissions, you'd find that in respect of each respondent, the matters we are dealing with in respect of both respondents, some of them are common and others are not common. But I'd urge you that if you had to give the Attorney General and the IBC a little bit more time, then on our part, an additional 5 minutes, since we are appearing for two respondents, would be appreciated.